Basically just is your toe hook there. You need a grease free, paint free ball for that, and then you've got your jockey wheel, which is up and down to steady the plan. Handbrake is as simple as handbrake off, handbrake on.
So there's no
button, no. And then obviously your jockey wheel, just loosen that off there and it pulls up into the halfway
on the trailer.
Just then it says
just be polite.
13 pin connector,
yeah.
That's all we've got.
Yeah. Yeah.
So inside, we've got your gas bottle right here. Is this their pigtail?
Yeah, I'll fit it in ready to go for it.
This is your pigtail. It's just standard screws on. It's got the hand tight one. It's just got the rubber on side, so you just need to hand tight that and just switch your gas bottle on. This is your regulator.
So is this off at the moment, yeah?
That's on the gas, we've got the gas on because we've got the system primed up ready to go. Is that our gas bottle?
No, that's their gas bottle.
That's their gas. So your gas is set off, so before you go, we'll close it off. That is your safety on off. Well, that's more for when the engineers are playing with your van.
Okay?
Yeah. So basically, when you go to travel, just turn your gas off.
Don't bother touching
it. No, don't, just leave that on, just turn your gas off before you go anywhere.
Right.
And you've got multimeter handle inside,
as well as your wheel brake.
Which isn't in there.
That is your wheel brakes as well, and then everything else is just at the side here for you.
So now we'll go around to the outside. This is your water heater, your heating system. So that needs to come off before you turn when the heating's on, because you've got a heat exchange out there. So
that's almost has to be off.
When you put the heating system on, that needs to come off.
Yeah.
Well, it's the hot water boiler, this one is. So if you run your hot water boiler on electric, you can leave the cover on. But if you want to run the system on gas, you have to remove that cover.
Oh, right.
So if you're running it on electric, you can leave it on. And if you want to use the gas, you just need to remove it.
We'll more likely do electric.
Yeah, that's what
it's in. Yeah, so this here is your water. It's just pull the button, pulls out. Pumps on the bottom. To make sure that's nice and straight, it's not curling up, because otherwise it'll just suck loads of air in. Just simple, wiggle in, and it's in. This is a filter.
I wouldn't love to screw it, loads of water coming.
This is for 32 days of use, so it's not 32 days you have to change it, it's you can use it.
Continual 32 days.
Yeah, so if you use it 32 days in a row, then change it, but otherwise if you use it for one day and then a month later another day, it's just it's how much it's used.
Right. And where do you get those filters from? In the shop?
We sell them here in the shop, yeah.
This is your external shower pipe. Have we got the?
No, it doesn't come in as standard, but you can get an attachment to go on there, so you can run an external shower. It is only a cold shower, so it's only good for rinsing the dogs off or your boots, but it's there as an option if you want to add it on.
And then that can go down and
just rest
like that.
And this is where your battery goes. This is our demonstration battery, but we will fit your battery before you go.
Okay.
That's your mains battery. Then you've got your external satellite point in there as well.
No, just
you can see that.
See that.
Yeah, and then obviously you've got your mains hook up there, just as simple as pull it out, off.
Yeah.
And then up to there. And then this is your isolator key for your motor mover, which we will demonstrate at the end how that works properly. And
now, just regarding the battery, if we have like a solar panel stuck under the window, either inside or outside the window, and the cable's going down, either outside or inside, can they simply just, with the chop block, not the chop blocks, the crocodile clips, just simply straight onto the battery and that's it?
I will ask an engineer on that one.
I
wouldn't know personally, so I'd rather ask someone that does know, and then we'll get back to him.
It's for triple charge, basically, when the caravan's...
Some of the vans have solar panels fitted to them, but they're already wired directly into the system. So I wouldn't know on an external one, but once Alex is explaining one bit I'm happy he's doing, I'll disappear off and I'll go and answer the question for you.
Yep.
Next is, of course, I've got the key.
Yeah.
I think the cassette might be open, so I'll show you the cassette for now. toilet cassette on if it's the same as the one you used to have.
This one's a nice trolley dolly one, so no excuse for the ladies.
Hey!
Yeah, they're unisex toilet cassettes, hey!
Right, okay. So, to empty normally it. Normally that goes onto the waste master.
Yeah, right? Yeah, not anymore.
So, to empty it. It's just.
Yeah, we've got a.
Yeah, so like say, cap full of blue liquid, cap full of water. Yeah, tip it in there, cap full of water. So it breaks down all the
nastiness. So you only put a cap full of water in your
bottle? Yeah, well, you could put about a litre in if you wanted to, but it just fills it up.
Yeah.
Usually about, usually say, a cap for every cap of
all blue. All it is you just want the liquid in the bottom so it starts breaking down all the goodies.
So to empty it, it's got an airlock. Press the button.
Bit of a shit sit. Conversation to have, innit?
Thank you very much. We're here all week.
I know, just when you pull, just do so, you pull it back out again. Keep going there. Right, so that was loose then. I just take it was just.
Yeah, that was just not being clipped in.
Right, okay.
That's all it is. That's part of you, when you open it inside, that pushes it back.
Yeah.
What it does when you slide in, that removes that cover off. Right. When you pull it back out, it just slides back in.
Okay.
Yeah, we've got your flush tank. I don't know if you've had one of them before. Flush tank for your toilet?
No.
Nope. So in here, basically, it can hold up to about 5-6 litres of water. Put your pink fluid in there with your water.
How much? They all vary on the dilutions of them. So if you read on your bottles, it's not an exact science. All it is a nice smelling fragrance. So when you flush the toilet, it's a nice smell.
In there,
they should.
And
when you
put the water in there,
literally just tip it straight in there.
Is it literally you can when it comes to the top?
You
of
can that, fill it up to the top.
You can do. It depends how much you're going to use it. If you're on site and the toilets are close, like 20 metres away, I'd only stick a bit because you're only going to use it morning and night, really. If the toilet's right on the other side of 200 metres away, then I'd stick a bit more in.
Depends how much of Stella Artari I drink.
Yeah.
Yeah. Once it's filled, the only way to get it out is to flush it, is that
no.
Right?
No, come into that now. So, but always drain it down before you go, because if you filled it up, and you've got 5-6 litres in there, the van gets a bit of a sway and it could slosh out and start coming into the van. But to drain it down, simple as this little tube here, pull the cord out.
Suck the end.
Well, you can't.
No.
Won't
just put it out and it drains down. If you want to suck it, you can, I'd laugh, and I'd
say. Usually what I'd say to do is if you get, you know, a juice bottle with the handle on the top, once you've got your mix in there, if you get a juice bottle with the handle on the top, just drain it into a juice bottle, stick it back in the gas locker and it's there ready to go for next time. It's only your flush water.
Oh, right, okay.
You know, save you going through loads of pink liquid when you don't need to.
Right.
So, any more questions there? Are you happy with that?
Yeah, happy with that.
Okay.
Are you happy with that?
She had nothing to do with
that. Yeah, when I undid that last time, I couldn't get the door open.
It might have been that special. One was locked. And
oh, right, you have to push
them. Yeah, you have to push them both, but that one locks, you know, to stop everyone getting in from the left.
So I'll come to around the back, wheels, legs there to wind down.
Right.
We use the legs, but we use a drill. Makes it a bit easier. Cordless drill, you can buy an attachment, which you see on ours there.
Yep.
Literally take you.
Do that again.
One time you'd
getting that on camera.
We should test
all night.
Erin with his drill.
Got an act, you
shit woman.
We have got your storage locker, we've got your spare wheel in there. Now it is nice and big under there, but when you're towing, keep that relatively free because it will start to get a sway on behind you.
Oh, we
you
can't put
Cadris
in there,
then. Cadris being the daughter.
No, not when you're towing. Not when you're towing down the road. When you get to site, you can shove her in there and anything else you want.
But bear in mind, she can get out through the bed, so I'd lock that down as well.
The dogs will be on the bed.
Yeah. Well, fridge vents. As you'll notice, this one here has got a bit of heat glass because we've got it running. This side, when it's running on gas, it will exchange a bit of heat from there.
All right, okay.
As you can see, it's nothing too exciting. Door is on a catch there, so you literally just pull the catch, door release. But if you've got anyone with you or having a drink, just make sure you point it out to them because we do replace a lot of these catches through people just pulling the door open without pulling the catch.
That'll be
so
you
when you've
then.
Had a few too many Stellas.
Just remember that it is on a catch. And it is also barn style door as well. I don't know if you have
born in a barn.
So when you've had too many cellars and we've got the bottom bit over, you just straight over the top.
Yeah, we've got a wet locker, so if you've been out walking, your boots are wet. Or
put your feet in there.
Yeah, stick them in there. Yeah, I've got an external 240 as well.
Now, is that switched at all inside the van, or is it always live?
No, it's always live. Always as soon as you're plugged into the mains, that's live for you.
Yeah, and
don't get sticking your fingers in it.
External gas pipe.
That's for barbecue.
Yeah, external barbecue pipe.
Right.
Okay.
And that is about as exciting as we get outside.
God, we still
got
your
warning light. Which works off.
We're going in.
Oh, hang on, not yet. A couple of things. Hang on.
The awning light works off there. And as I believe it should have a switch.
You have to have it switched on inside, right, though. Well, when you've got it on inside,
you can remotely turn it on and off. Or it says light.
Oh, good, isn't it? I never noticed that.
As long as it is turned on inside.
Now, is that a factory fit or is that an afterthought?
It come on the alarm system, so the alarm that's fitted to the van as well.
Right,
so,
okay.
I believe it would be a factory fit.
Yeah, so for your alarm, if you press the button, one press.
You need to look at first.
Two beeps on.
We've got a bird in there.
One beep off. That's as complicated as the alarm gets.
Is it PIR sensor and that's it?
No, tilt sensor as well.
Tilt sensor as well. So if anyone hooks onto your van and tilts it up, it'll kick off.
Excellent. And then your PIR is just on top of the roof there for you.
If anyone gets inside and starts moving about as well, it will go off.
Okay.
One thing just before we go in.
Oh, and your wheel set.
It's not on the door on these ones, but it's 115 for your wheel nuts.
It's 115, yeah. Your torque settings for your wheels is 115 newton metres. Now, I don't know if you've got a torque wrench or not.
No, they have at work, but...
Well, if you can't get access to a torque wrench, just every time you go to travel with it, you know, every time you go to take it out, just get your wheel wrench on, just make sure they're tight. Don't jump on it by no means, because as you know, with alloy wheels, you can crack them. Yeah. Quite easily.
Yeah. Do you know the PSI for the tyres?
No, I don't know on that one. If we don't know, we just don't pass it on. But for your wheel nuts, they've been talked in the PDI. We will talk them again today. Yeah, for them, from moving on forwards, it's down to yourselves to be checking.
Okay,
so before you set off, as he's already said, just get your wheel wrench. And it's just make sure your wheel nuts are tight. That's all you're checking for.
Standard stuff that I do with the trailer anyway.
Yeah, exactly. The same.
Not checking to that.
It's a bigger trailer, isn't it?
It's just a bigger trailer. Yeah.
Just slightly.
What I do need to know is what PSI we're talking about.
I'll go and ask.
Grab an engineer and ask them for you.
On the Swiss, they're on the door, so the information's there for us. If it's not, I'd rather get an official word off one of the guys rather than guessing at what your tyre pressures are.
Right, okay.
Inside we go.
Yeah, and it's nice to have a step here this time.
Let's get me seeing the crime shoes on and I'll be joining
We weren't given them.
Oh, imagine if we dirtied your van, though, we'd get in some trouble. Right, so we need to get under here now to start with. I will show you.
Sit here. Yeah.
So, down here, you've got your water heating system. The drain valve for that is there. So, there's your water heater, there's your drain valve. So, if that's before you go anywhere or when you pull up to site, always put that down. Before you fill your system. With this system as well, always before you turn it on, I will show you the heating for it, but before you turn it on, always make sure there's water in it. If you don't take anything in today about what I've told you, please take this in, because if there's no water in there and you turn it on, you will pop the element. You will burn the element out.
And just run through where you fill the water in for that again.
The water from there, that when you turn the pump on and you prime the system up, will drag the water out of the Aquarol straight into the system.
Oh right, okay.
So
right.
You can turn your water pump on to get your water in your system, but don't turn the heater on until it is full of water, because you will burn it out.
Okay. So it's one input, the Aquarol will serve all the taps.
Yeah,
and
the Aquarol will serve
the
everything. Yeah. The shower, all your taps. And your shower will run off that.
So much better.
Yeah. So like I say, to drain it down, just simply flick that up, open the taps, let it drain down, and then just leave a tap open while you're travelling, and then then it's going to drain down properly for you. Like I say, as soon as you want to fill it back up, just drop it down again, and away you go.
Is it full now?
It is full now. We've primed it up for demonstration purposes.
And can I drive with it full?
Yeah, you can.
Are you going out in it tonight?
We're thinking of going out in it this afternoon just for a
We're going to drive up the A5.
We're going to drive up the A5, which is huge. We're going to come back down again. Just to...
You're going on the bypass for your first drive?
Yeah. Mm.
Okay.
Why?
All it is the only thing, when you're on a dual carriageway, if a big wagon comes past you, it'll wake your eyes up, because when a truck comes past you, it will suck your caravan in, and when they pass you, it will spit it back out.
I've got a trick for that. Move the car into so the caravan on the right-hand side of the caravan is as close to the white line as possible.
Yep, perfect. That's
when the wagon comes
say.
By, just as soon as he's sort of halfway past you, move back into the middle.
Perfect.
Father-in-law.
Absolutely perfect.
Father-in-law.
And he's
trick.
Going on a course. Yeah.
So what are those two taps there for? The red ones?
They are
gas shut off valves.
Gas shut offs.
So do I need to do anything?
Don't then? Really need to worry. They're more for the engineers if you bring your van in for service and they okay. want to do something to it. Our main advice is if you smell gas in the van, go and turn the bottle off.
Right.
Go outside and shut the bottle off from there.
So that won't be my curry the night before.
Just thinking that.
Down here, yeah, I've got your consumer unit.
Yeah.
You've got your mains, 240 trips there, 12 volt fuses down there.
Okay.
So if any of the 12 volts aren't working there, any 240s, have a look there first.
Yep.
And then if they keep tripping, then obviously you've got an individual problem that you need to address.
Okay. Now, is there any temperature setting for the water? Can we alter the temperature at all, or is it a preset temperature?
There is two different gauges there on the electric side. It's either two.
So if you read on it, it will tell you which switch is which.
Oh, in the corner there.
Yeah,
it's like a rocker switch.
It's like, I think it's roughly. It's got three bars and two bars.
Right,
so if you look down
it's
there.
Roughly. The top one is 50 degrees and the bottom one is 70 degrees. So push, click to the top is the sort of medium temperature.
So if we do it to there.
Clicked all the way down
yeah.
is your high temperature.
That will
right,
be
okay.
to high temperature. When it's in the middle, it's off.
Right, that's
yeah.
fine.
Because you've got 10 litres of hot water, the hotter you get that water, the more cold you're using. So if you imagine in the shower, with your mixer tap, you'll be using less hot and more cold. So it means you get longer in your shower. Where obviously if your hot water's a cooler temperature, it means you're using more hot and less cold, so you won't have so long in the shower. Because all
totally
it is...
totally frazzed my brain now.
So basically, right. if you say if you imagine, if you've got 10 litres of water in your tank at 70 degrees,
yeah.
when you go to get in the shower and you set the tap, it's going to use more cold to cool that water down and
yeah.
drag less hot through,
yeah.
so your shower will be longer. If your water's only 50 degrees... you're going to use less cold and more hot because it's not got as much cooling down to do.
Okay. Yeah.
You got that?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah. I should be testing
so
you later.
I'll just tell you as well, just like I said, you've got the top is the colder setting, bottom is the hotter setting,
oh,
the middle, it's
bit.
Off.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do we need to leave it off when the
leave
caravan,
it off, yeah.
When the van's not in?
When the van's not in use. Every time you're getting ready to go, turn it off. Because like I say, if you get back in and you just plug it in, and that is already on and there's no water in it, it will turn on and it will pop your system.
When you say when you leave the van, are you on about leaving it for storage or leaving it when
leaving
you're on
it,
the site?
When you're on the site, if it's full of water and you want to leave it on to keep it hot for when you come back, that's fine because you know there's water in it. But if you've got it in storage or you just and you're taking it home or you're on your way to site, make sure it's off because if you get to site and plug that straight in and that's
right.
already on like that, and you've got no water in your system, that boiler will kick off straight away.
Right.
And it's like boiling a kettle with no water in it.
Yeah.
The element will go.
And is it like a tank at home where it's like a ball cock in it, as soon as it's empty it starts refilling?
So what the tank does, it's got constant flowing water through it. So imagine when you're pulling off your hot's coming off the top and it's refilling the cold in the bottom.
Yeah.
But what it is, so when you run out of hot water, all it is your hot water will go stone cold. It's just the hot water will disappear. Once it has, you just need to shut it down and then give it sort of 10-15 minutes, let that tank heat up for you, and then you're back to
start.
Your full 10 litres.
15 minutes?
It all depends on how cold it is outside, how cold your water is and things, but roughly it's about 10-15 minutes.
That's good.
Okay.
Yeah, so next we'll go to your control panel here.
Well, this is a confusing bit.
Well, it's not too bad, this one.
Simple, these ones.
Master switch, turn everything off. All your 12 volt off.
Everything.
Yep.
Apart
from
the fridge.
Fridge and I believe the,
yeah,
the heater down there.
Them off.
So that needs to be turned off, physically turned off, and your fridge turned physically off. But this will turn the rest of the 12 volt systems off. So on. Simple as that. Water pump, that's off, that's on. I'll show if you want to turn the tap on just for a second. Turn, pull it out towards me, sorry. Typical
bloke,
didn't
that?
That should light up in a second when the pump kicks off. There you go.
So that's the blue pump outside?
Yeah, that's to let you know that your water pump's on. So when you get in the van, you want to fill your system up. You get in, you come in, you make sure you've got your 12 volts is working. Plug into the electric outside, turn your pump on. Simply to the cold side. I believe that's cold. Yeah, so you run it to the cold side, let all the air kick out the system. As you see.
It'll only splutter now because you had the pipe off before.
Yeah, because it took the pipe off. So once you've got constant running water on the cold side, shut it off, over to the hot side, open it up again. It will cough and splut to get rid of all the air out of that tank, because you imagine you've got 10 litres of air. Once you've got constant running water on the hot side, then you can turn the water on, you know, your hot water heat on. So that's how complicated that is. Nice and brain baffling.
We'll be referring to these videos more.
So your lights are when you turn all your lights off, you will. Some of them are 240, I'm guessing.
Hey. Yeah.
Little so you'll spots. Notice when you turn them off.
These.
Some
are on the 240. Some are on the 12 volt.
Yeah. So the ones that stay on. Are on the mains, but as soon as you unplug it from the mains, you'll notice that the power will disappear. But they're all independently switched. Everything has got an independent switch for it.
Probably somewhere.
Oh, they're everywhere, and so they're just on the side, underneath there.
So everything has got its independent switch.
Are these ones?
If I turn the switch, there you go.
So that's your
12 volt. That's your 12 volt.
That's
240 lights are all the ones which stay on there.
So when we turn this off, anything that goes off, anything that stays on now, anything you can turn on.
So basically, the 12 volt is run from the battery, and the 240 volt run from the mains.
Right, and that's the whole 12 volt thing there. That's not anything to do with mains at all.
Well, when your mains is plugged in, obviously you've got your breakers in there, so that's what the only thing that will sort of switch your mains off. Once your mains is in, it's sort of powering your van up. So it's just like plugging the Hoover in at home,
but what I'm saying,
what I mean? And that's just switching everything on.
Right, okay.
Okay, yeah. So if you notice when I turn that off, that's everything off now.
Right.
But all he's saying about the switch here, these are just the lights that are just on the 12 volt system.
Right.
Okay, so this light switch just does the light above your head there. Okay. All the main reason for that is when you come in and when you initially walk through the door, you can turn that one single light on.
Yeah.
So you're not walking in the dark and trying to find the light switch over there. You've got this instant light there, which is just your entry light there as such.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
That there is your master switch for your awning light. So.
And then that's controlled by.
Once that's switched on there, you can do it by the key on and off. So as you're coming up to the van when you've had a few drinks, you can press it and you know where you live.
The awning has to be on in here for it to work on the key.
If it's off there and you're pressing the thing thinking it's broke, come in, check if that's on. If it's not, then you know you've got an issue with it.
Yeah.
Oh, one thing I don't think we address is the battery charger.
The battery charger on this one is automatically wired in. So as soon as you plug your mains in, the battery charger's running, recharging back at your 12 volt system for you.
And does it also run off the car as well?
Yep, so when you're plugged into the car and you're going down the road again, it will automatically run the battery charger and top that battery up for you.
Will it only charge it when the car's running, or will it charge it when you connect in?
Yeah, no.
Charge it when it's running.
Yeah, when the vehicle's running.
It'll need the power of the alternator to charge it. Basically, just like your alternator charges, so it'll be drawing power off the alternator to charge the battery charger, which is one thing I forgot to mention when we were down there.
So, electric down there for your water boiler, and then...
That's it, and here we have got the gas. Yeah. So, top one, 50 degrees, bottom one, 70 degrees for the gas, middle, it's off. And I believe I'm right in saying you can run both at the same time.
Yeah, you can run them both at the same time. So it just speeds up.
If you're in the winter and you find your water's not heating up quick enough, flick it onto both onto the top one, and it will boost that water up quicker for you. This is your electric heating system. So you've got roughly 500 kilowatts, 1,000 kilowatts, 2,000 kilowatts, and there's your thermostat control.
And is that from
heated off the water?
No, that is running. That heater there is then running now, just running on just electric.
So inside your fire there, inside gas fire. Burners as well as electric, right. element, as okay. the two.
There's nothing.
It will take a bit to heat up, but right, it's not okay. instant, it's
just,
instantaneous.
Yeah, it's right. just started.
And then what about blowers? How do I get that to...
The
to...
blowers are here. So if you look down here, you have got thermostat blower. That's off. That will thermostat. So if you've got it set to 3 and you've got the fire on, the heater will go off once it senses it's up to temperature. Once it drops below the temperature, it will then kick in again. So if you've got that set to full whack there and you've got the blower set to 3 like I have, once the thermostat realises that it's up to temperature, it will go off. If you want it constantly running, just until you say stop, then it goes all the way up to 5. Now in the summer, if the van's hot, you make sure your heating's not on there or you're not running on the gas, you can literally just turn this on, put it on 5, and it will drag cold air in from the outside and circulate it around the van, just to give you a bit of a breeze. Right. This side is the gas, so we'll turn it that side. So this is, as you can hear it kicking off, that's the clicker for the gas, but you can't run this on gas and electric. I'd just run it on one or the other.
Right.
Don't.
So where do you operate that again?
So as soon as you turn it to 2 there, you'll hear the clicker going. All you do, press it down, that lets the gas out.
Just turn it off, turn again, it off and just again. Leave it clicking.
So, can you hear it clicking? No, it's because I've had it on. Like,
I can hear it clicking.
Yeah. Turned can it you? Straight on. So,
I've got tinnitus, so everything's clicking.
Can you hear it clicking now?
Like, oh, it's lit no. straight away.
It's lit itself. Because I've just turned it off, it's literally rewriting itself. But I'll leave it off for a few seconds so I can.
Yeah.
There you go, you can hear it ticking now.
Yeah,
perfect.
So, ticking there, because basically, when you first come into it, it'll just tick. You just hold it down to let the gas out. As soon as it stops ticking, let your finger off. If it's not ticking no more, it's lit.
And then we can work that all the way around to 10.
All the way up to 10. And like I say, you can put your blower on, and then that'll blow it all around the van.
So, what it is, if you've got it on the A.
Was that on there?
Automatic.
If you've got it on the A, thermostat controlled, it'll do the same as what it
again,
does
again, they're not instantaneous heat. So yes. What's happened now, the burners are kicking up and the burners are heating that fire up.
Right.
But not until it gets up to temperature. So if you've got it on 10, the fire will wait until it's at maximum output. Then the fans will kick in, blow the air around for you.
If that's on thermostat,
it will shut off
once it gets to temperature.
Okay. Yeah.
But like I say, if you've got it on manual, it will just run. But if you leave it on thermostat, it will just do its job.
And will any heat come out of
there? Yeah,
it'll come out of there, and it'll come out of your air vents that you can see all around the van.
Yeah, they do take a small time to heat up. It's
it will be quicker on, probably quicker on gas than it will be on electric, I'd imagine.
I should imagine we'll use electric more than anything, to be honest.
But I would leave it on thermostat, because can you imagine if you've just got it left on constant and it just keeps running, all of a sudden you're like...
But the best advice we can give you today with your gas, although you say electric, just have the knowledge you know how to run everything on gas. So if you're ever on site and you've had a power cut, you're not the couple throwing the manuals and effing and jeffing at each other because you can't switch anything on. Just have the knowledge how you convert everything over to gas, and then if you are ever in a situation, at least you know how to convert everything over to gas.
Okay.
Yeah.
So next we'll go to your cooker.
So you'll be talking to me about this, I would imagine.
So you got the 12-volt igniter there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's as simple as he says. There we go.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Electric there, 1 to 6, and it will indicate there when it's on.
That's for the back burner, isn't it?
That's for that one, electric ring there. Down here, grill pan.
That's dangerous.
And,
perfect for 4 pieces of toast.
You got a toaster? Yes.
Just like you grill at home, basically. Just blow it in, get it going. Oven. Nice and simple with the oven, just like it is at home. And it's lit.
Yeah. Okay with that.
Nice.
And then underneath, got your pots and pans storage.
Yeah.
Now, there is a plug down there. There.
What's that for?
That's for your electric ring.
Oh, right, okay.
So,
is the colander still in there, or has that been taken out? There was a colander.
Oh, was there really? Yeah. Oh, well, I don't know, I haven't looked.
Right at the back.
No, that's gone. So if you if that's not working, I'd put money on it. You've put a pan in there and not the plug. And
okay.
As you will look down here, you have got some gas shut off valves, which relate to your cooker. I wouldn't, like I say as well, if you smell gas,